Asian river ants are one of the coolest species of ants in the whole world because of their unique ability to make leaf nests. However, these exquisite ants are notorious for being extremely hard to obtain, contain, and raise in captivity. In this video, I'll share 4 tips on how to keep Asian river ants and how to implement them. This is my river ant colony. I caught them sometime in March and they are now 100 days old. Before we start the tutorial, I would like to put a disclaimer that I'm not a river ant expert. I've only caught 10 river queens through my 3.5 years of ant keeping and only have this one colony that reached 100 days old. The reason that I'm making this video is that there is a lack of information about methods to keep river ants online. As such, I am recording this to share my own experience to give ant keepers some ideas on how to keep the river ants. As my experience with river ants is only limited to 100 days, this video will only be covering the founding stage of a river ant colony. If you don't mind this fact and would like to see my experience, carry on watching. I will start by briefly covering the basic information you would need to know about Asian river ants. River ants are scientifically known as Ochophila smaragdina. They are a claustral species, they are arboreal and cannot live in regular formicaria, they are an aggressive species and have large whorls that possess strong bites paired with potent formic acid. They are fast growers that can grow into super colonies in a couple of years. You need a lot of time, space, food, and money to house these species. Now for tip number one, you should keep your river ants in a well-lighted area. River ants are an arboreal species, meaning that they live on trees. They have very good eyesight and heavily rely on it for hunting and activities. Putting them in the dark like a normal ant colony will eliminate their ability to see and thus cause stress. Light will not cause stress to them as they're already accustomed to the bright sunlight. I keep my river ants on top of a table where they can get access to natural light. However, I do cover up their setup at night to simulate the daylight cycle. I'm not sure if that step was necessary, but it worked for me. In summary, allow your river ants access to light to optimize their eyesight. Tip number 2, keep your river ants a well-ventilated setup. In the wild, river ants' nests are exposed to wind and get high ventilation. High ventilation prevents mold growth in the setup. However, I wouldn't recommend leaving your river ant queen unprotected as she would be defenseless against pest ants which are likely to climb onto your table unlike trees. I placed an outwall around my river ant queen with a lot of ventilation points. In summary, keep your river ants in a well-protected and well-ventilated setup. Tip number 3, make sure your river ants are set up with high humidity. In the trees, they get a constant amount of humidity through the transpiration of the leaves. On top of that, they are native to the tropics. The natural humidity levels here are very high. I've seen tutorials where people say that river ants could be sensitive to temperature as those that live in air-conditioned rooms die. However, I think that it makes more sense if it's a lack of moisture in air-conditioned rooms that kills them. In summary, keep your river ants set up moist and away from the AC. Tip number 4, give your river ants multiple nest options. Normal ants dislike being exposed to large areas as open nests would mean opportunities and weak points for predators to attack. However, river ants don't mind living in open areas. The trees that they live on are usually massive. When making their nest, they'll create a layer of silk as protection from the weather as well as predators. You can take advantage of this ability of the river ants and allow them access to a large area for them to choose where they would like to make their nest. This will ensure that the ants are constantly living in the place that they believe is the best for them. When it comes to survival, they make the best decisions. In summary, don't be afraid to allow your river ants multiple nests. So altogether, the 4 tips are giving your colony light, ventilation, humidity, and multiple nest options. With these 4 tips, I will now show you how to keep river ants in a practical setting. First things first, ditch the test tubes. I already made a video explaining some of the reasons why I dislike using test tubes. On top of these reasons, test tubes will be unable to utilize tip 2 and is too small for the river ant queen to comfortably move around. A boiling tube will be much better. There are multiple cases of colonies surviving through boiling tube setups. Personally, I find that a modified container setup works best for river ants. First, you need a small container without a lid. Put a wet cotton ball inside to provide humidity. Next, put this container in a well-ventilated outwall for protection. Leave this outwall on a table with access to light in a room without air conditioning. Once you get workers, place this outwall into a tank with a plant. When they are ready, they'll move in on their own. You are probably thinking, why not just let them have a plan from the start? Honestly, I have no idea why, but personal experience tells me that they seem to do better inside a container setup. Some other benefits of using container setups over plants would be that you, the innkeeper, can have more time preparing a setup for the colony, and have the ability to easily and safely move them around in the case where you decide not to keep them. For viewers living outside the tropics, it will probably be extremely hard to obtain a healthy weaver ant colony. Keeping ants in the temperate region is completely different from keeping ants in the tropics. But if I were in your shoes, I'll keep my weaver ants inside a tank with conditions matching the tropical climate, which is definitely a challenge on its own. Anyways, comment down on your experience with weaver ants down in the comments below, and subscribe if you found this video helpful. Anyways, that's the end of the video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!